Hi children, welcome to e-class. Today we are going to discuss about methods of separation. Before I start this, let's we discuss what we were in the previous different soluble things, insoluble things, and some of the materials or objects will float and sink in the water because of the density, or if the materials are mixed together, we call them as a soluble. If they are not mixed together, then we call them as a insoluble of the materials. So children, when I was started this lesson, in the introduction I said if the boy when the mix of the materials, he has to be separate in a different method, isn't it? So simple to complex, already I used to say this lesson or methods are depend upon the simple to complex. Whenever you do the anything also, if you draw a diagram, you have to first you make a, for example, if I draw a diagram like leaf, so just I make a borders like this. So these are the borders, and then I can make inner the parts, isn't it? So the inner parts like I can do, isn't it? Later I have to slowly make what are the parts also I have to separate, isn't it? So this is the simple method when we do any activities. So simple to complex, so easy to difficult also we can call them. So yeah children, methods of separation. So we have to take the object when they are mixed together, or one or two object mix, then we have to separate them, otherwise it's not nice. For example, your mother, when it is a pick out of some stones in the rice, possible to cook these stones together the rice? It's not at all possible, because while we eat, the stones also has to be disturbed and it should not enter in our stomach also, isn't it? So this is a very simple and common example I said. Let's see simple to complex methods, how we can separate of the materials. Hand picking method, what is this one? Hand picking method. Children, especially in a villages, maybe in our town or some the metropolitan cities, maybe it's not a possible to this kind of the things we see, but in a villages usually, or in a normal places, we can see how our mother or grandmother or some villages elder people used to be take a hand fan, and then used to be clean whatever the stones, pebbles, small pebbles are presented in the maybe rice or dal or some other different food grains, isn't it? After a completion of their in the mill, rice mill or somewhere, they has to come and they separate with hand picking. If the big stones, small pebbles are there, you know, immediately they take with their hand. So then it is called as a hand picking method. With our hands we can separate the materials from rice to small pebbles or the stone, isn't it? So that is a very simple thing and simple method, isn't it? Let's see winnowing method. So this is a from the olden days and till continues. So the people of the farmers used to be do this winnowing method. So we know that winnowing method. So this winnowing method, we used to make husk from food grains. So what are the food grains are there? So this is the separate, we know the husk is a which is the unwanted one. So there is no rice, there is no seeds, or there is no rice in that husk. So it is lightweight from the food grains, isn't it? So this is the very
easiest method, we have to go to the near of the direction of the wind. If the wind is south to north, or when the direction of the wind we have to see, then we have to go a little upward, and we have to make with the separation of the husk from the food grains. When you just drop these food grains from little upwards to down, then when they through this float, sometimes you can put the fans also. When you put the fans, it has to be force of the weight, force of that what we say, air, that husk has to be go from away from this food grains, isn't it? Then food grains has to be come down, and to compare of this husk will away from the food grains. So this is also very easiest method and the oldest method also, isn't it? This both also very simple methods. Next one is the sedimentation. What is the sedimentation? Sedimentation and the decantation, this both also very very important. Like when we have this what is the water scheme, when we'll get the water from the municipal areas or water tank, no? They first of all they used to take from the rivers or the ponds or some areas. Then when there is a water with the mud, it has to be separate of the methods, we'll discuss in a later stage. But that is the one kind of the sedimentation, decantation. And another one is when we used to be get from the river water or pond water, when before the rainfalls or sometimes cyclones, the water is mixed with the mud or the soil, then what we have to do? We have to take that water and without disturbance we have to leave them. Then after 1 hour or 2 hours, all the mud particles has to be come down bottom. Then we have to separate fresh water from this mud particles. So this is called sedimentation, isn't it? Next one is sieving and filtration. What is the sieving and the filtration? Once again, when we see some of the what we say, pebbles, and some again very tiny stones or dust particles are presented. When we sieve the things like flours, powders, wheat flour or maize flour, we can't separate them because very tiny particles there. So in that also we can separate with the help of this sieving method. And what about this filtration? So already I said about the mud particles or dust particles only we can filter, not more than, isn't it? Only dust particle and mud particle only we have to separate, which are mixed with the inner observe of this mud particles we cannot separate. That is another method is there, isn't it? Only dust particles only we can separate with the help of this filtration. For suppose water is mixed with sugar, is it separate with this filter paper? It's not possible. It has another method, I will tell you later, isn't it? So sieving is a very tiny, like a wheat flour or maize flour or some other particles are, we have to divide from a tiny small pebbles. So we have to use a sieving method. And also food grains also, some of the large pebbles cannot be separate after hand pick, after winnowing method. So again we have to do a little tiny holes, little more than little large holes has to take, and we have to separate from the pebbles from the food grains, isn't it? So these are the very simple methods of the separation. So later we'll discuss remaining methods. Have a nice day. Thank you.
Children, have you seen how your mother removes bran and other impurities from flour? They separate the coarse bran from the fine flour with the help of a sieve. This technique of using a sieve to separate the solid components of different sizes in a mixture is known as sieving. In this method, the mixture is placed on the sieve and shaken. The smaller particles pass through the holes of the sieve to the container placed below and are thus separated from the bigger particles that are retained in the sieve. During your numerous train trips down your countryside, you would have noticed women standing at a height, shaking a basket held over their heads continuously. They are separating the grain from the husk by simply allowing the wind to blow away the husk and other lighter impurities. The heavier grain falls down on the ground in a heap. This process of separating impurities from the grain by allowing a current of air to blow away the lighter impurities is known as winnowing.